Victorians caught up in the dark Tuesday storms, fires and blackouts are pleading for help as they try to get back on their feet. The pleas come as the bushfire toll soars, families wait for power to be reconnected and a town fights to recover after it was ripped apart.
In Merbau North, there are as many trees horizontal as vertical. And the ones still standing look more like giant matchsticks.
Disaster, really. The worst disaster that could happen to a little town.
Trees uprooted, houses crushed. There's no power, no lights, and for many, no food.
Honestly, I'm not trying to feel sorry for myself, but I was starving. They gave away free sausages at the park for the community yesterday, so we went and filled up on sausages.
And residents are taking the clean-up into their own hands.
People on the ground will do more help than the government, that's probably the truth.
Leaked records show when Victorians called 000 for help on Tuesday, they waited up to 6 minutes.
It was the busiest day on record for Victoria Police call takers.
Today, the Premier announced power relief payments.
$1,920 a week for up to 3 weeks for residents.
But only for those who go more than a week without electricity. In the Dandenongs, Alex Cowan has now gone 4 days without power with 4 kids.
Yesterday we had to make the call to purchase a generator, which costs hundreds and hundreds of dollars.
These people need $1,000 put in their account because half of them haven't been able to go to work, got no food.
With Victoria's grid reliability in the spotlight, a report by AusNet has found 1 in 7 of Victoria's ageing transmission towers are damaged by rust. The average age of the towers is 57 years old and the vast majority don't meet modern safety standards. Across Victoria, 90% of the people who lost power have since been reconnected. But as for the other 10%, it's going to be a really tough couple of days before they can even start thinking of getting back to a normal life and enjoying the little things.
I miss the cricket.
You miss the cricket?
Yeah. I miss the cricket.
Tyra Stowers, 7 News.